Meanwhile, their friends have the problems which we are discussing that are electrostatics problems, and we are learning different types of the techniques to solve different types of problems which are linked to the electrostatics. So here it's another problem where two equal and opposite charges of magnitude 2.2 multiplied by 10 to the minus 7 coulomb are placed 15 centimeters apart. Here it is 15 centimeters apart, that is minus 1.5 meter. What is the magnitude and direction of electric intensity E at the point midway between the charges, and what the force would act on the proton of charge that is 1.6 to 10 to the power minus 19 placed there at this point? This is the charge placed, and you are asked to find the magnitude of the charges. This is Q1, this one is Q2. Here is Q1, then it's Q2. That Q is placed at point A, minus Q is placed at point B. Let R be the separation between them. This one is R starting from this point, ending up to this point. It is 0.15 meter. What you are going to calculate first, you are going to calculate magnitude and direction of E at point C. So this is the point C, and you are going to calculate magnitude of electric intensity at point C and its direction. So here it is. The magnitude and direction of force E acting on proton C due to Q1 and Q minus Q. The intensity at C due to Q1 is, here is the formula to calculate the intensity. It is KQ1 divided by R1 square, and it is equal to putting the values for the Q1 and the distance that is R1 square. Then you have calculated E1. Same formula you will use for E2, but the charge will be Q2. And the distance will be R2 square. So after putting the values, you have calculated E2. Here you have calculated E1. And here you have calculated E2. Newtons per coulomb. You are calculating intensity for both the charges. And the resulting intensity will be the intensity due to both the charges, that is Q1 and Q2, and you will add these two. After adding, you are getting the total intensity acting, and this R is the unit vector which shows the direction of the intensity. And if you convert into newtons per coulomb, it will be along AB because the sign is plus. Now let the proton of charge QP, charge of proton is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, which is placed at point C. As in figure, now the Coulomb's law, Q1 and QP will be this one. Where is the charge of proton? It is the charge of Q1, and this is the distance between the two, 0.75. So after putting, you have calculated F from the force acting on the proton of charge this one, then you have calculated its magnitude. Now let's calculate the Coulomb's force between Q2, that is this one, and this one, charge proton placed at point C. So here it is. After putting the values, you have calculated F2. A force acting from charge 2 on proton. Then you will calculate the total amount of the force acting. That will be equal to F1 plus F2, because it's at center. So the both sides it will be facing some force. So if you look at that is 5120 plus 5120 multiplied 10 to the minus 17. This is common for all. And after taking common, you have added these two, got this value, and then you have simplified it. 10 to the power minus 13 newton, and this R is a unit vector which shows the direction of the force, and which is along A to B. This one is A to B because this is along the same direction. The direction is not changed because it's carrying positive sign. So here it is, and you have calculated the force which is acting between the charges when a charge proton is placed between the two charges, that is Q1 and Q2. First you have calculated charges due to Q1 on proton, and then you have calculated the force due to Q2 on proton, and then you have calculated the total force acting this one on both the charges. Thank you very much for your attention.